Today we'll be talking about how to take care of your timpani mallets here on the Percussion Discussion. So first things first, how do I store and transport my timpani mallets? Well, my first recommendation would be using the plastic bag that your timpani mallets originally come in. The most fragile part on a timpani mallet is the felt cover on the top. Any friction with other mallets and sticks in your mallet bag can damage this cover and even cause it to fall off after a bit of time. So, when you place your timpani mallets in that plastic bag before placing it in your mallet bag, you now have a barrier between the felt on your timpani mallets and anything else that would cause it damage to that felt. So, once you get it in that plastic bag, just go ahead and throw it in, and your timpani mallets are nice and protected. My second recommendation would be using a tubular bag or a stand-up bag opposed to a folding bag. Standing and tube bags like this one allow mallets to move around a lot, gives them a lot of freedom, and most importantly, there's no compression on the mallets when they're in transport. Now, with a folding bag, you have mallets that are on both sides, and to close it, you're literally squishing those mallets together and zipping them up, causing a lot of compression between mallets. This can cause a lot of rubbing between any mallets and sticks in your bag and your timpani mallets, which puts you at high risk of damaging the felt cover on your timpani mallet. So, if one is available to you, always try to use these standing and tube bags with your timpani mallets just to ensure you don't have that damaging compression. The next thing we want to think about is the playing surface we'll be using our timpani mallets on. Now normally, we'll only be using our timpani mallets on timpani heads, and maybe some multi-percussion setups if it calls for it, although I recommend using some cheaper mallets if you're going to be playing on a multi-percussion setup. The felt on a timpani mallet can be easily damaged by heads that have a very rough pattern to them, or instruments that have a lot of ridges to them, because the ridges and that rough pattern can pull on the felt and damage them very quickly. So, always ensure that you're playing on a smoother surface, just like a plastic or calfskin head on a tympanum. And then the next thing that you want to worry about is particulate matter. Dust and debris are not friends to the felt on your timpani mallet. Over time, it can build up in the mallet, and number one, your mallet can actually start damaging an instrument if it's got too much particulate matter in it. And then second of all, your felt is going to start to be damaged if you have a lot of particulate matter building up. So, when you walk up to a tympano or whatever instrument you're going to be playing, check the surface and make sure there's not a lot of dust and debris on it. Now, sometimes the covers that we take on and off of timpani can get dust and debris on it, and then it'll put it on the head when we actually put the cover on. So, go up to the head, just maybe swipe at it, make sure there's not a ton of dust on it, and if there is, just take a black towel or whatever cloth you may have on you, make sure it's not wet, and wipe down the timpani head to get all of that matter off so that it's not going to be damaging your mallet over time. Last, but certainly not least, is maintaining the mallet itself. Now, no matter how much care you take while playing with and transporting your mallet, it's going to start wearing down over time, and you'll see this come in two stages. The first stage is where you have the felt itself just start breaking down, and you'll see large strands and large pieces of that felt start to come off your mallet. And this is how you can take care of that. If you see just large blobs of felt just kind of sitting on the edge of your mallet that's really loose, just go ahead and pick that off, and then if you see strands that are coming out, go ahead and cut those down towards the head of the mallet. Don't cut the head of the mallet, but just cut it down towards that felt head. And here's why. Those pieces can get caught while you're playing or while you're transporting your mallet and pull on the felt on the head and cause a lot more damage. So taking those flakes off and cutting off those different strands will just protect what's left of the head and keep what's intact intact. And then the second stage of the wear on your mallets is when you're going to have to replace the cover. Normally, if you start seeing holes in your cover, or if you have parts on your mallet that just aren't covered with a ton of felt, that's when you're getting to the point where you're going to need to replace the cover on your mallet. Now, I actually don't replace my own covers, and if you don't, I recommend going to somebody who actually knows what they're doing when they're replacing timpani covers. The felt covers are tedious when you're putting them on, and there's a couple different types of stitches and types of covers that you can put on there according to your preference. So if you do get to that stage, find somebody who does have experience in doing it and either get them to change out your felt covers on your timpani mallets for you or have them teach you how to do it. Thank you for joining me here on the Percussion Discussion. If you have any questions or suggestions, go ahead and leave them down in the comment section. And if you want to see more percussion related content, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and I'll have more content out soon. Take care. Goodbye.